Hi, thanks for joining me. Today I'm going to show you how to make this treat holder. And you can see the cellophane bag here on the side where it actually holds a couple candy bars. This project's really easy to make, but I'm filming the video because number one, it's a club project. And number two, I wanted to show them how to attach this heart treat cup. This is a special that we're having right now. And if you need more information, you can send me an email or check it out on my blog. Okay, so I'm going to move this over here. And this is the actual flyer that shows the promotion. Okay. The very vanilla, you know, what I'm going to do is go ahead and give you the measurements of this so I don't forget this time. So the main piece is very vanilla, and this measures 11 by 3 1/4. And you're going to score it at 1, 5, and 7. Okay. There you have it. This very vanilla piece measures, I think, like 2 1/2. Yeah, 2 1/2 by 2 1/2. And this is just where you're going to stamp your greeting. The Sending Love specialty paper, this measures 3 1/8 by 3. And this little piece measures 3 1/8 by 7/8. Okay? So. First thing I'm going to do is actually go ahead and stamp the Love You Much. I'm going to use Real Red ink, and this is the Well Scripted stamp set. And you can stamp it anywhere on this square because we're just going to take the heart punch and punch it right out. And I did forget to show you one other piece of cardstock that you're going to need. I'll get that in just a minute. In your supply bag, you're going to have an extra pink heart, and you're going to attach this to that. Okay, so for now, we're just going to set that aside, okay? This heart, of course, came from the punch, and then this heart came from the punch windows with the movers and shapers, so I have a video on how to use that if you need help with that. Okay, here's the front of the box. So before I attach the designer paper, I need to punch a hole so that I can attach the cup. Okay, so see, the cup is gonna fit. So when you're doing this, you need to make sure that you bring the cup up high enough that it doesn't extend past your paper and that it doesn't extend past this paper. Okay, so you can either put it in the middle just to be safe, or if you put it over to the side, just make sure you watch your edges. I'm just going to put this one in the middle because I've found that it's a little bit easier to do that. And then save your heart. You can use that on something else. See, look, isn't that cute? Now, everybody's asked, how do I attach that to that? Well, I figured out a way around that, so you don't even have to worry about attaching it, okay? So here's what you do. Just take your adhesive, your snail, and put it on the back of this cardstock. And then put just a little bit, or a lot, whatever you'd prefer, on that piece. So what you're going to do is put your cup in there, put this piece here, and then when you go to attach it, now it's stuck in there, see? Perfect. Okay, so now the next step is you have a couple choices. What I like to do is just staple this. Here's your bag. You're going to put your candy inside. And then what I like to do is staple that. Of course, once you staple it, then you can't get access to the candy inside. So I'm not going to actually do that because I'm actually going to give this to one of my club members that couldn't make it today. So I'm going to not staple it, but you would staple it at this point, then add your designer paper, and then I'm just going to put just a smidge on here so I can pull it back up so she can use it. And then you would take your ribbon, and this is the new satin ribbon in the Occasions Mini catalog. There's 14 inches I've included in the kit, And then you just tie it. And I'm not going to trim the tails of the ribbon because I'm giving this to my club member, so I want her to be able to finish it once she puts her candy inside. So there you have it. Trim those though. Okay, so if you have any questions, let me know. Thanks a lot. Bye.